Hello students, in this lecture I will be discussing about curl of a vector. Now curl of a vector is represented as del cross F or curl of vector F. Now this is given by dou f3 by dou y minus dou f2 by dou z I cap plus dou f1 by dou z minus dou f3 by dou x j cap plus dou f2 by dou x minus dou f1 by dou y k cap. Now if you remember the definition of determinant of a matrix, now I write I, j and k in the first row. So the first component is I cap into dou f3 by dou y, so I write dou by dou y of f3 minus dou f2 by dou z, so we will have this, so we get I cap into dou f3 by dou y minus dou f2 by, this should be dou z. So the remaining terms can be filled up in this manner. This is dou by dou x of f1. We also observe whether it is gradient, divergence or the curl. If we write one term, the remaining terms can be written by using the cyclic property. Now since the definition of curl is similar to that of a determinant, I repeat, similar to that of a determinant or a cross product of vectors, the second row here is not a vector. Therefore, I use the word similar. Similar to cross product of vectors, we write or we make use of this symbol for curl. As I said in the previous video, that every symbol that we use in vector calculus has a meaning. For gradient of a scalar, we do not use a dot. The resultant is a vector. For divergence, the definition is similar to a dot product, so we use del dot f. Whereas for the definition of curl, because it is similar to a cross product of vectors, we use del cross F. As an example, let us consider the curl of vector F. Now by definition, curl F is I, j, k, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, f1, f2, f3. So this would be an easier way of remembering the definition of curl of a vector. So this will be expanding the determinant dou f3 by dou y minus dou f2 by dou z I cap. As I said earlier, if we write the first term, the remaining terms can be written using the cyclic property. So f3 becomes f1, f2 becomes f3, y becomes z, z becomes x, j cap plus f1 becomes f2, z becomes x minus f3 becomes f1, and x becomes y, and j becomes k. Now we need to find these derivatives and substitute. Now f3 is xz squared minus y squared z. We require dou f3 by dou y, which is minus 2yz. We also require dou f3 by dou x, which is z squared. Then we have f1 will take f2. f2 is 3x squared y. We need dou f2 by dou z, which is 0, and we also require dou f2 by dou x, which is 6xy. And we have f1 equal to xyz, and we require dou f1 by dou z, which is xy, and we also require dou f1 by dou y, which is xz. Now if we compare the partial derivatives required for divergence, we require partial derivatives of the components with respect to the corresponding variables. But for curl, for each component, the partial derivatives that we find is with respect to the other two variables. That is, if I have f1, we find dou f1 by dou y and dou f1 by dou z when finding curl. Similarly for f2 and f3. Now if we substitute this in the definition of curl, we get curl of f is equal to dou f3 by dou y, that is minus 2yz minus dou f2 by dou z, which is 0, into I cap plus dou f1 by dou z, that is xy, minus dou f3 by dou x. Dou f3 by dou x is z squared, j cap, plus dou f2 by dou x, that is 6xy, minus dou f1 by dou y, that is xz, k cap. Now to understand the geometrical meaning of curl of a vector, let us consider a rotating rigid body. Rigid body under rotation with angular velocity . This is vector omega. This is a constant vector. We have a constant angular velocity. So linear velocity is vector v. Now, the relation between linear velocity and the angular velocity is v equal to omega cross r, where r is where v is the velocity at any point xyz. Now that point xyz, the position vector of that point is given by vector r. So r vector r is xi plus yj plus zk. Now if you consider, now omega cross r, this is I j k omega 1 omega 2 omega 3. If we take omega 1 omega 2 and omega 3 as the components, so we have x y z. Now this will be omega 2 z minus omega 3 y I cap plus omega 3 x minus omega 1 z j cap plus omega 1 y minus omega 2 x k cap. Now if we take curl, we have v is equal to omega cross r. So if we take curl on both sides, curl of v is curl of omega cross r. So this will be, applying the definition, I j k dou by dou x dou by dou y dou by dou z. Now f1 in this case will be omega 2 z minus omega 3 y omega 3 x minus omega 1 z omega 1 y minus omega 2 x. When we simplify this, we have I cap into dou by dou y of this term will be omega 1 minus dou by dou z of the second component will be minus omega 1 plus j into dou by dou z of the first component will be omega 2 minus dou by dou x of the third component will be minus omega 2 plus dou by dou x of second component will be omega 3 minus dou by dou y of first component will be minus omega 3. So we have curl of vector v equal to two times omega 1 I cap plus omega 2 j cap plus omega 3 k cap, that is 2 times omega. So therefore omega equal to 1 by 2 curl of vector v. Now this tells us about the geometrical meaning of curl of a vector. We find that if v is the velocity vector, linear velocity vector, then curl of velocity vector is 2 times the angular velocity, and hence the name is chosen, curl of del cross v is chosen to be the name as curl, because it represents rotating phenomena. And if you look at the dictionary for the meaning of curl, something that is rotating is called a curl. in the next video, we will be looking at the problems on curl of vectors. Now, another outcome of this geometrical meaning is, what happens when the curl of a vector is zero? If the curl of a vector is zero, that means there is no angular velocity and therefore there is no rotation. So the vectors where the curl is zero are called irrotational vectors.